You think Tommy G's a culture vulture?
Yeah.
His ass
crazy. Like, he's been everywhere. Like, it's kind of hard catching up with him, too.
I thought there was no way you were going to say yes to that question because you seem like you guys are actually friends.
No, he what'd you say?
A culture vulture.
What's that mean?
He mean like, do you?
Usually it's considered a negative thing of like a white dude who goes to the hood and kind of like makes money or gets something.
Off nigga shit.
Yeah.
Type shit.
But he just like.
He seemed like a good dude to me.
He like adventures and shit. Like, like seeing new things. So that's just like, why? But he lives like in Milwaukee. So.
Right. He just has such a good nature and such a positive mentality that I feel like that's why a lot of people are willing to welcome him in.
Yeah. And it's like his fans is like different. Like, his fans love him.
They love you too.
Hell yeah. That's after that video. Like, they was like, hell yeah.
Yeah.
They love him though. Like, his comments is crazy.
Definitely. Yeah. Okay. So who would be your dream feature, like dream artist to work with?
Future for sure. Motherfucking a Future song. Fucking Uzi song. Probably like Drake. I wanna hear some shit with Gucci. Probably, yeah, probably like some. I don't know.
That's a good lineup.
But I know for sure Young Boy sound fire as a bitch on my song, on my beats though. That's what I kinda like. Where he from? Louisiana.
Mm-hmm. Baton Rouge.
Baton Rouge
type beats. Like, them the type of beats I like and shit. Yeah, but I used to listen to Gucci a long ass time. That's why I said that shit, though. Mm. But right now, like, you know the turned up sounds and shit. Like, I'm coming out with a new song.
Who's the rapper that hit you up that you were the most excited about?
Damn there, Baby Tron. A couple niggas hit me up. It was like 600 Breezy hit me up and shit. Who else? Not that many people. Face, Baby Face.
Mm. For real? Yeah. That's fire.
I'm gonna get some shit with Face.
Y'all definitely gonna knock something up.
I used to listen to that nigga, man, all day.
A fact. You been in Detroit yet?
Yeah.
Well, of course. You from Milwaukee. Mm-hmm. What's the differences from like Detroit and Milwaukee, like that you can see? What's the differences to you?
Detroit got a big ass rap scene.
Mm.
So it's just like, it's big, like Michigan big. So it's like, it's not like Milwaukee and shit. But they definitely got some, top 10, 20s and shit like that. That's why it's big. Like, they got a lot of people.
I got a question. Back in the day, were you bumping that, "Tell a bitch Milwaukee, I need my bucks"?
What song is that?
He said, I don't know that.
There was an LA rapper who had a song called Milwaukee. Or Milwaukee Bucks, yeah. I don't think I heard it. It's a good song. I would have thought that people in Milwaukee would have been hyped on it, but.
Nah, they wasn't feeling that. They probably already been doing a lot of Milwaukee Bucks type shit or Milwaukee songs, you feel me?
Yeah.
I think it's only cool if you're not from Milwaukee.
The punchline might have seemed played out to them already.
Facts.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you heard that shit. Because a lot of people don't know nothing. Nobody, like, from Milwaukee. Yeah. Most places I go, they're like, bro, I don't know. No rapper from Milwaukee.
I don't either.
I just met you type shit, yeah.
I know Mark Cuban.
You fuck with Super Throw Dave?
Yeah, I fuck with
him. Yeah, that's the only other one I think I know. Like, you, Dave. Oh, no, I'm here to Carvey P, too.
Carvey P, yeah.
Mark Cuban owns the Bucks, right? Mavericks. God damn it.
He out here blowing these references. Blew the fuck out that reference.
This is No Jumper where we know nothing about basketball.
And I don't know shit about basketball.
When we pretend to know about basketball, we get it wrong.
Goes wrong every time. Crazy.
That's what I mean plenty of fucking basketball players and I just be like, I don't know who the fuck.
Oh my God.
Is.
That's
yes,
crazy.
I've been in nice ass restaurants and had these 8-foot tall motherfuckers come up to me being like, I fuck with your shit. And I'm looking at them like, I know you're a famous basketball player, but I have no fucking clue.
That's insane.
Yeah, I gotta work on my shit. Even if I watch it all the time, though, I don't think I remember their names.
I need to actually go to the games and shit like that.
All right, so you see it. We just hit 500K. You know what that means? That means you gotta subscribe and get us to 600K because we are dangerously close to 666K. Let's go.